Hello and welcome to this video about rational and irrational numbers, which are key components of the real number system. Today we're going to explore these two subsets of real numbers that you encounter every day, often without even realizing it. Rational numbers are the familiar ones, the ones that you use in daily life, like $10 or 3/4 of a cup. And then there are the irrational numbers, which are less obvious but equally fascinating, like the square root of 2 or the constant pi. This Venn diagram is a visual representation of how real numbers are classified. You can see that rational numbers include natural numbers, whole numbers, and integers. Natural numbers comprise the smallest subset, which is also known as the set of counting numbers. These are all positive, non-decimal values starting at 1. Whole numbers encompass all natural numbers with the addition of 0. And integers are whole numbers and their additive inverses, or negatives. Rational numbers include all the sets seen here in addition to some values in between. An easy way to remember this is that the word ratio is in the name of this classification. All numbers included in the rational number set can be written as a ratio of integers. Rational numbers are any numbers that can be written as a over b, as long as a and b are integers and b does not equal 0. For example, the integer 3 could be represented as the fractions 3 over 1, 6 over 2, or even negative 24 over negative 8. The integer 0 could be represented as the fractions 0 over 3, 0 over negative 2, or 0 over 123. Fractions can also be written as decimals. For example, 13 over 100 is equal to 0.13, because the 3 is in the hundredths decimal place and the 1 is in the tenth decimal place. This is an example of a terminating decimal. Other decimals have repeating patterns. These are considered rational because they can be expressed as a fraction. For example, the repeating decimal 2.17 repeating represents the digits 2.17171717 and so on. And this can be represented as the fraction 215 over 99. It's important to note that not all decimals are repeating. Some decimals have an infinite number of non-repeating digits. These types of real numbers cannot be expressed as a ratio of integers and are therefore classified as irrational. While there are an infinite number of irrational numbers in the real number system, those most commonly used in mathematics are the square roots of non-perfect squares, like the square root of 2, for example, and the constants pi and Euler's number. The notation for irrational numbers allows for efficiency in mathematical applications. Let's take a look at some example problems involving rational and irrational numbers. Example 1. Determine if the following numbers are rational or irrational and explain your reasoning. A, negative 2, B, 0, C, square root of 7, or D, 1 over 3. A is rational because negative 2 is an integer, which is a subset of rational numbers. B is rational because 0 is a whole number, which is also a subset of rational numbers. C is irrational because the square root of 7 is approximately equal to 2.6457513, but this is an infinitely non-repeating decimal. And D is rational because 1 over 3 is equal to 0.3 repeating, and any repeating decimal or number that can be written as a fraction of integers is a rational number. Example 2. List three rational numbers between 3 and 4. For this example, let's stick with decimals. We can keep it simple and just do 3.25, 3.5, and 3.75, but in reality, any terminating decimal like 3.58 or 3.987 would work in this scenario. Remember, any number between 3 and 4 that can be written as a fraction would also be correct. All right, that's all for this review. Thanks for watching and happy studying.